Scarlett LeNoir. Mexican. Jersey for much of my life, but I moved around here and there. I got into acting pretty much from high school, just to plays, just for fun, because I've always wanted to act, but I didn't have the outlet other than school. Then I tried some productions here and there with other jobs that I did. I always felt acting to me was a way of therapy. Acting was something where I felt that I could just disconnect from what I was going through, just pretending to be someone else, trying to live another life. My character is Rose, and her background is a strong woman with a couple of obstacles, again, like most people go through. She kind of like carries it a little bit more deeper. She's trying to balance a good relationship with her brother and her fiance now, and with also within herself, because she wasn't accepted by her family for being transgender. With the help with friends and her fiance, she's able to build a deeper connection with her brother and everyone around her. Well, Shane contacted me through email, and honestly, I'll admit, I was kind of reluctant when I got the email, because I have played transgender characters in the past. I wasn't really written appropriately, I guess you could say. I was either a sex worker or something like that, which is, it's sad that that's how the media is, but you know what, that at the same time, you know the saying, there's always a truth in stereotypes, because it comes from it, and you know, most trans girls or individuals are kicked from homes and go through that really early in life, so that's the only way to support themselves, which is sad, but that's how just the media just kind of like recognizes trans people. And when I read the monologue, because Shane put that in the email, it was pretty much just, it could have been a character that it didn't have, it could have been for anybody, not even a specific trans person. It was just about a boyfriend and her trying to find a connection, a deeper connection than they already had, because they've been dating for a while. So that's why I responded, and also I've always wanted to continue to acting. But before Shane contacted me, I just didn't want to play another trans role. I related a little bit within everybody, like with Maya, and I've had friends who've gone through it, so I can kind of understand it within from them. With Jamie being, was an immigrant, I still deal with that. DC having to come out with family, and especially like a sibling, that was really hard, so I kind of like gone through that myself. With Dylan, still finding myself as a person, I was always very awkward around people because I didn't know how to act around people, especially pre-transition and post-transition. I didn't know how to, I knew I wasn't myself pre-transition, so I made myself act a certain way around people, and it wasn't always the best. Sometimes embarrassing, sometimes carelessly, and sometimes I kind of like butted heads with people. I was still figuring out myself, and it was really hard finding a new personality for myself. Even having to deal with like the mundane little things in life, having to wear lipstick, having my hair down, growing it out, wearing something feminine. Like, those are mundane things to most people, but after my transition, it was liberating. There's Maurice, her fiance, who she's put through a lot, but stuck with her. Then there's Josh, her brother, who's an asshole, hard-headed, stubborn, childish, wild. But once they get a form of a good relationship, you see that he's a good guy. He has it a little bit more tougher than she has now. She has to still be a brother and a sister, because she had to pretty much put herself in his shoes, losing a family member. We're like, he didn't lose through death, but through a different form of a brother. So that has to be hard. Me being transgender, I kind of put myself in my friends and family shoes, especially my mom. My mom was very supportive, but she did cry a lot of the times, and she thought I didn't know about that. And I honestly didn't really realize that I was, in a way, being selfish, that I was taking a son away from a brother. So taking a brother away from Josh has to be really difficult for a really young age. Veronica, his girlfriend, who's now the mother of Rose's niece. Bethany is a bit of a reward because she fought through keeping her brother at a good path and worrying for him so much and fighting for him. And I mean, I personally, for me, I feel like that's a good reward to have. Mine is Angela. She's just very funny. She's a grandma. She doesn't act like one. Yes and no. I think he respects that she has her way of dealing with her brother. At the same time, him being the male figure for Josh now, he feels that he could step in within reason. At the time, like now, we have good shows that have trans characters who are actually portrayed accurately and stuff like that. So like when I got contacted for StillsTheSeries, it wasn't really anything like that. So I felt kind of lucky that I was early on to play a character that is written very well. I feel very fortunate and lucky to experience and to play a character like myself, since I'm trans, like very well written and portrayed accurately. About the timing, I guess, you know, we did start a little before every other shows did it, but you know, it's never too late, and there's never a bad time to tell a good story.